I'm Kim Barber with Kim Barber Group and eXp Realty, and I've helped thousands of owners and agents with real estate since 2004. Buying a home is such an exciting time, and what I want to share with you as an experienced agent, there are four things I think that you must do and really think about as you start your buying process that will make your experience better and keep you from making some very critical mistakes that you don't want to find once you're actually getting in homes and ready to sign the contract. And during this video, if you have some questions about this, please go ahead and leave a comment below and I will try to help you out. And if you end up finding that you like this information, do us a favor and give us a quick thumbs up so that YouTube can like us and we can give you some more information. So that being said, here are four things that I think that is critical for you to know and realize that are important as you start your home buying process. So the first one is to think about your plan and your timeline. So what is it that's driving you to want to buy your home now? And that's what I want to ask you. What is it that is making you want to buy a home now? And the reason that I ask you is A, motivation. And there's nothing worse than thinking that you want to do something, but you're not really motivated to do it. So that internal conversation, ask yourself, am I really ready to do this? Because let me assure you, it's stressful. And if there is something though that is driving you, like my lease is up, having your timeline also takes away the stress if you can get ahead of it. So what I wanna encourage you to do is map out a timeline. They say anytime you have stress, but you have a plan, that keeps you out of like chaos, right? And so what is your timeline? What is driving you to need to move? Is there a deadline? Are you relocating? Are you getting married? Are you getting divorced? Are you buying your first home? What is it? And then develop that timeline, right? And then from the end of that timeline, let's say that your lease is up, I'm gonna give an example, June 30th. The life cycle of buying is about a 90-day life cycle. So if you need to be in your house by June 30, May 30, April 30, March 30. So you really wanna start getting in homes and starting to look at them in person around that 90-day mark and give yourself some time to find the right home and then start making offers, right? And so you really wanna be making that offer to give yourself the 30 to 45 days to actually close. So map that out. So the other thing is that you want to find an experienced agent. Right? There are lots of agents out there and pretty much everybody knows, like if you don't know one, great. If you're in Northern Virginia, give us a call. But everybody tends to know at least one agent. The critical part is, do you know an experienced agent? Or if you have a newer agent, but they're on a team with experienced people, that's okay too. But it's really important to have an experienced agent like myself, who can do things like I just mentioned, like let's map out your time, let's backdate, let's do a reverse plan so that we know when we need to have the different stages. All of our clients get a unique plan, whether they're buying or selling. And you wanna have an agent who's gonna be able to help you with the other phases, which is basically making sure you're connected with a good loan officer who will talk with you through your budget, and then some of the other things, which is the question. So first you wanna map out your plan, you wanna find a good agent, and then I just mentioned some things about a loan officer and questions. So a good agent hopefully will then also have what I call a buyer consultation with you. And that buyer consultation with you will include two parts. In our consultation, we talk about what is your financial situation, meaning how much do you want to have your payment be? How much are you thinking you want your sales price to be? How much do you have for a down payment? And then any other things that influence your mindset, like if you want a condo, like what's your tolerance for a condo fee? And so those things are going to help us see if you have realistic expectations, if you can buy more than you think, if there, what is the right product, the home style that will match what you're looking for. So basically you want to meet with an agent within the time frame that allows you to map these things out and then start getting what I call this consultant information, right? So that they can start to advise you about maybe where to start looking. And then also you want to now be connected with the third part, which is a loan officer. Right? A good loan officer will help you also understand, again, what is your budget? How much do you need for down payment? What are your closing costs gonna be? So you have your money down for the down payment for the loan, but there are monies that it costs to actually close the loan and the process for taxes and the title company, and you need insurance and and all of these different things, right? So there's two parts to that money, which is the actual down payment, and then there's the cost that it takes to close on the loan. And so you wanna go ahead and understand these costs and make sure that you're prepared financially, right? So you have your timeline, you're talking with an agent who's gonna start to help you map out some of these key parts, your timeline, your money, what you're looking for. And then the next and the fourth part there is to actually go through some key questions. If it's just you, that's fine. Maybe write these things down, maybe collaborate with anybody, your friend, family, or if you're buying with somebody else, obviously you'll wanna make sure that you do this together, because I cannot tell you how many partners, family members, husbands and wives actually don't. They look at each other like, what? I didn't know you wanted that, you know what? And so a couple things, what's ideal? What's your dream home look like? And you know, if you're not ready to buy the house on the ocean in Greece, whatever, but the dream home within the scope of what you're trying to buy. So what is an ideal dream home look for you right now? What are the top three locations that you want to live in? And what is the criteria that you need to have in that home? What are the things that are influencing those answers? Is it the commute? Is it the lifestyle? What are the experiences of things you need to be near? Is it family members? Is it hobbies? Is it airports, et cetera? So again, to go through that again, you want to really make sure you have these four things down when you are thinking about, you know, getting in the game of buying your home, which is the timing, your loan status and situations and getting pre-approved. You want to make sure that you have the right agent, and you really want to map out what does that ideal home look like within your budget and within the area that you're looking to buy. If you can get those four things down, you're going to start off to buy your home in the right way. And again, if you have some questions, go ahead and comment below. If you like this information, do me a favor and give me the thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, and we'll be giving you a lot more information so that you can have your home ownership experience and your real estate life the best way that it can possibly be.